Hey guys, Michael here from The Daily Note. So have you ever wondered why 4K videos look so much better than 1080p videos even on your 1080p monitor? Well, it is because of something called chroma subsampling and how by design it discards 50% of the data before it is even recorded. It has been a limiting factor on virtually all 1080p video that has ever been captured on a smartphone and virtually all consumer video cameras. However, the new phones and cameras coming out with 4K recording capabilities like the Galaxy Note 3 finally has all the pieces to the puzzle to capture real 1080p video in a way that no 1080p video camera has ever been able to do in the past. So let's take a closer look. So let's look at some samples. On the left, you can see a 100% crop of a 1080p video straight out of the Galaxy Note 3. The level of quality is something similar to any smartphone or even a dedicated video camera. And on the right, I've captured 4K video on the Note 3, then shrank it by 50% to make it the same size as 1080p video. If you're watching this video in 1080p, you will see a pretty big difference in the quality due to a limitation brought on by chroma subsampling in the 1080p video on the left. To understand what chroma subsampling is, let's look at a grid of pixels representing 1080p video. It is approximately 2 million individual dots of color. Let's zoom into a single pixel, which is made up of three different pieces of data. The luma value y tells us how bright the pixel should be. And the two chroma values CB and CR tells us what color the pixel is. Now some of you might be thinking, hey, I thought computers use RGB values to process color information. Most of the times that is correct, however, when we're talking about video data being recorded on consumer products today, it uses YCBCR, not RGB. So let's forget about RGB for the remainder of this video. So back to our single pixel in a 1080p image. In a perfect world, every pixel should have its own Y, CB, and CR value. This is known in the industry as 444. However, since we're dealing with 2 million pixels, that is quite a bit of data. And what engineers have figured out is that as long as we keep the luma, aka brightness information of each pixel, we can share the color data of one pixel among three neighboring pixels. What this means is that 75% of all color information is discarded, but with the benefit that we are left with 50% less data. This is known as 420 chroma subsampling. It is how every smartphone, pocket camera, SLR camera, and even most video cameras record video today, and will probably continue to do so until the foreseeable future. Even with chroma subsampling, 420 1080p video still looked good enough to be called HD video just a few years ago. However, as our technology and tastes improve over time, we can see that 1080p video still has a fairly large room for improvement. Unfortunately, all consumer video recording devices have conformed to the idea of 420 chroma subsampling and never looked back. And although we have reached a point in our consumer electronics to handle the data of 444, there really isn't any push to improve 1080p video recording. So this is where 4K comes in to improve existing 1080p video. In a single pixel of 1080p video, there are now 4 pixels at that same location when shooting 4K video. And even though 4K itself is also being recorded at 420 chroma subsampling, we can extrapolate 1080p video from it. All the pixels in the extrapolated 1080p video have their own individual Y, CB, and CR values. Thus, we are reconstructing uncompromised 444 1080p video. And this shouldn't be taken lightly. 444 1080p video has been unobtainable from even professional cameras costing of upwards of tens of thousands of dollars until just recently. So that's why 1080p video looks so much better when we're working with 4K video. In a way, we're able to utilize all the pixels of 1080p for the first time. Just a few tips. I've tested converting 4K to 1080p video on a couple of applications such as Adobe After Effects, Premiere Pro, and GoPro Studio, which all seem to do just fine converting it to a crisp 1080p. I'm sure a lot of other popular software will do it just fine. You'll even notice that when you upload 4K videos to YouTube and watch them in 1080p, the videos look much more detailed than when you upload 1080p videos directly. So that's it for today. Even if you never buy a 4K TV for the rest of your life, you could still benefit from recording in 4K pretty significantly even on a 1080p monitor.
So if you've enjoyed this video, make sure you give it a thumbs up and subscribe if you haven't already. And I don't always say this, but if you know people that might appreciate the information in this video, I would absolutely appreciate it if you shared it. And as always, thank you for watching.